Good morning, children. Today, I would like to explain to you an important math concept, the concept of skip counting. Okay, let's look to skip counting. Skip counting. How many of you have heard this word, skip counting? Yes. Skip counting means you jump from one number to another jump. Another number, like a kangaroo. You jump from one number to another number. Now, let's skip count by 10. That means every jump is made with 10 numbers. For example, 20. So, the next jump is 30. Next jump, 40. Next jump, 50. Okay. So, here the tens place. Check the tens place, how it is changing. The tens place moves one number forward. Okay? Okay. So, this type of counting, it goes forward. So, it is counting on, moving forward. 20, 30, 40, 50. Now, let's take one more number. Okay? Let's take one more number. Suppose we take 24. So this next skip count will be, for 10 numbers will be 34. Then it will be 44, 54. So you observe that the tens place is moving one number ahead, while ones place remains the same. Ones place remains the same. The tens place only moves because it is skip count by 10 and it is skip count on. Okay, it is skip count of 10. It is skip count of 10 numbers. Okay, very good. So you have understood the concept of skip counting. When it is skip counting, that is moving forward. Now let's take one more example. 38, the next number will be, if it is going to go forward, it will be 48. Okay, then it will be 58. Then it will be 68. Okay, so the tens place keeps moving one step ahead or one number forward. So it is called counting on. Okay, suppose I'm going to write 3 and we have to count 10 numbers. For it, you can use your fingers. Okay, use your 10 little fingers and let's do the counting. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. Yes, it's 13. Okay, very good. Then after 13, if you want, you can again use your 10 little fingers. It will be 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Very good. It is 23. Otherwise, you can see the number is moving forward. It is 43. Wonderful. Now, let's look to one more number. Okay. Now let's look to one more number. 4. Okay. Count 10 numbers. It is counting on, moving forward. So counting by 10 means take your 10 little fingers. Very good. Take all the fingers out and keep it in front of you. And start counting 4, 5. So don't start counting from 4. So for the next number. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Wonderful, 14. So the next will be 10 more numbers. Tens place you can move forward. So 34. So this is called as counting on. What is it called? Counting on or moving forward. It starts with 4 and ends with 34. It starts with 4 and ended with 34. Very good. Now, let's look to a number when the counting is going backwards. So let's see how we can count when the numbers are going backwards. Okay, 90. Back counting. So back, 10 numbers back. 80. 70. Back 7, 60. So you have to think of the numbers backwards. So it is called as counting back. Okay, 9, 8, 7, 6. See, it's going backwards, reverse. Okay, 50. Understood? Okay, so the numbers have gone back. Let's look to one more number. Okay, 50. Back, you get 40. Back, 30. You get 20. 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, it's going back. So it is called skip counting backwards. Okay, children, you have learned the skip counting backwards. So the best way to count the numbers is you can observe your calendars. I suppose everyone has a calendar at home. Okay, so you can look to the calendar and you can see the calendar is here. Okay, so the 10 numbers are there. So the first 10. So the next 10 will be where? At 20. Okay, at 20. Okay, next 10 will be where? Near, after 20, it will be 30. So you can go and learn the skip counting while you observe a calendar. In that, you can count the jumps by 10. Very good. Now, let's learn skip counting by 2. It's a very easy one. Counting on. So if I write 2, the next number will be, just take 2 more numbers, 3 and 4. Very good. So don't remember 3. So don't remember 2. Just go one step forward. Okay. Keep 3 and 4. Next one. Don't think about 4. After 4, 5, 6. Why do we take 2 numbers? Because the skip counting is 2 numbers. After that, 2 more numbers. What are the next number? Keep 7 is there, 6 is there. So 7, 8. Okay. 8 is here. Don't count 8. 2 more numbers. 10, 12. It's very easy. Okay, let's try one more. If you have taken 12, 2 numbers more, 13, 14. After 14, 2 numbers, only 2, 15, 16. 2 more numbers, 17, 18. So the skip counting is by 2. That means you have taken only 2 fingers after 18. After 18, take your 2 fingers out, 19, 20. It lands on 20. Very good. Now, if you want to see the skip counting backwards, okay, it is 20, 2 numbers back. Okay, so you'll have to learn to go in the reverse direction. Okay. 20, 2 numbers back. What is it? 19, 18. You have to learn to count backwards. 18. Okay, then 17, 16, then 15, 14. Okay? Then 13, 12. So learn to count backwards. Okay. Learn to count backwards. 12, student, 12. Okay. 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. So it's going, if you want, it is going backwards. Okay. If you count, this 20, this is 18, 16, 14, and 12. Okay. Now, children, let us look at one more number of skip counting by four numbers. Okay, so for that you have to remove four fingers out. So if it is 10, take out four fingers. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. How many numbers have been written? They have asked that many fingers you have to take out. Take out more four fingers, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, four fingers, 19, 20, 21, 22. So that's how you count. Understood? So 10 plus 4, 11, 12, 13, 14. After 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. After 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Understood? Okay. So this is skip counting, which is going on. So it starts with 10 and ends with 22. Okay, children. After understanding what is skip counting, let us look once again at skip counting by 10. Are you all ready? Okay. Now, if I give here 2, what is the skip count, the next number? Yes, count 10 numbers. It is 12 because you have added 10 numbers. Next number, 22. Next number, 32. Next number, 42. Okay, so the number goes on. So in skip counting, there's nothing to be scared about that. What is the next number? It is just taking out the number of fingers and adding. Okay, you can also do some activity while you're doing skip counting. Okay, you can do a jumping activity. So here is Jack. Jack, we can do a jumping activity when we are doing skip counting. How is it? Suppose the number is 6 and we have to do two numbers. So how do you jump from 6, 7, 8? Two numbers you have jumped. Okay, everyone can stand up and do the skip counting. When you are on 8, again you have to take two numbers. So how do you count? 8, 9, 10. Okay, then all of you can stand up and jump from 10 for two more numbers, because the skip counting is by 2. After 10, two more numbers, 11, 12. Okay, children? So you can do it as a form of an exercise wherein you will skip count and you will learn the skip counting. When it is 10, you take out 10 fingers. When it is 4, you take out 4 fingers. When it is 2, you take out 2 fingers. When you have to count back, you have to learn to count backwards. So you have to see if you are counting on or you are counting back. Okay, children, hope you have understood this concept. If you have not understood, you can as well ask me in the class. Thank you. Have a nice day.